no chastening for the present seems joyous but grievous. It is tough. Nevertheless, afterward, there's always an afterward with the child of God. In other words, whatever we're going through right now, we know that it's working together for good to those that love the Lord. My life is edited, and everything that comes into my life has already gone through the heart of God. God has to approve it, like Job. The Lord allowed the devil to do it. Why? Well, because the devil does the will of God. Did you know that? That's what the sovereignty of God means. The sovereignty of God is not God's right to act like a bully in his own backyard. Well, God can do anything he wants to. Yeah, exactly. But you see, we know the character of God. We know the heart of God. The sovereignty of God is God's overruling care and wisdom. Wonderful, isn't it? If men were allowed to carry on in their own way, we'd all perish. And so God overrules. I want to tell you something, folks. We sometimes forget. The devil is a creature. He's a creature who is dependent every moment of his existence on God. And the only reason God allows the devil to carry on is that he not only makes the wrath of man to praise him, he makes the machinations of the old devil himself to praise God. The things that the devil brings against the people of God, God overrules and actually uses them to make us more like the Lord Jesus. Isn't that what you read the book of Job? What happened? What is the book of Job? Is the book of Job written to explain the mystery of suffering? No. You get to the end of the book of Job, God feels absolutely no obligation to tell us why Job suffered. Job never did find out, as far as we know. It's not a book written about the mystery of suffering. It's a book that is written to reveal to us that even a wonderful man like Job needed to get his eyes off Job and on the Lord. And that in the darkest times and the most difficult times, what God felt was the answer to Job's desperate need was the revelation of God himself. And that's what God did, didn't he? He came down, he didn't answer any of Job's questions, but what he did was he asked Job a whole series of questions, and the answer to every one of them was God. Right? All the questions he asked, same answer every time. God, God, God. You start getting into the habit of saying that. Like, who holds the wind in his fist? God. Were you there, Job, when I designed the coastlines of the ocean? Did you help me there? No. Oh, I did it myself, did I? Yeah. And so he describes the whole universe, all the created beings. Job, I mean, did you help me stretch the rainbow in the sky? No. Oh, I did that myself, did I? Yeah. Well, obviously, implied in all of those questions is this. Job, could you just let me carry on in your life too? Could you trust me enough to let me do, without explaining to you all the details, will you just trust me and let me carry on? You see the end of the Lord? Twice as blessed at the end as at the beginning? Well, he says, that's my purpose for you too. Nevertheless, afterwards, it yields the peaceable fruit of righteousness to them which are exercised thereby.